Hi, I'm Ben Jump, and the short video aims to raise awareness of the tree disease known as Chalara Ash dieback. The European ash, Fraxinus Excelsior, is native to most of Europe and is the second most abundant broadleaf tree species in the UK, with an estimated 126 million trees. Its wood is used in flooring and furniture making, and it makes the finest firewood. Ash dieback is caused by a fungal infection known as Chalara fraxinea. Originating in Poland in 1992, it's moved quickly across Europe. It was first discovered in the UK in February 2012, and since then over 600 sites have been infected. We could lose over 90% of our ash trees during the next decade or two. Symptoms of the disease include crown dieback, and this can be seen in the trees in the middle of this picture. Canker-like bark lesions are also commonly found on infected trees, and leaves blacken and wither when they should be green and healthy during the summer. The fungi, or fruiting bodies which produce the Chalara spores, are small and white and may be seen on infected leaf stalks during the autumn. So what's being done about ash dieback? Well, biosecurity measures have been put into place, and all ash trees in infected nurseries are to be destroyed. The genomes of a native British ash tree and a resistant tree from Denmark have now been mapped, as has the DNA of the fungus. This could prove invaluable in finding long-term solutions to the problem, such as tree breeding programs. So what can we, the public, do to help? Well, consider buying shares in Natural Ecology Mitigation Limited. They've patented a fungicide called CUPC33. If you see infected trees, contact the Forestry Commission or in Northern Ireland the Department of Agriculture and Rural Development, and please clean your vehicle and footwear before visiting other ash woodlands. You could consider volunteering to help the Woodland Trust, whose Observe a Tree scheme aims to create a tree health early warning system. The DEFRA-funded Living Ash Project aims to use citizen science to help identify Chalara-tolerant trees. Finally, consider playing a Facebook game called Fraxinus, as this helps to analyse genetic data on the disease. That's it, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I've enjoyed making it, and thank you for watching.